here's some bad news. Bane was so mad about the Bird Bane mask that he broke Ellen's ankle. She keeps saying it was an accident, but that's exactly what Bane would have told her to say. I was really happy with last week's corrections. And we're gonna bring it down a little bit this week. What tonight lacks in length, it will more than make up for in mediocrity. You guys, the Bird Bane mask was a triumph. There's no other way to say it. And I even had a different way to end last week's correction. When I had the spark of inspiration that led to Bird Bane mask. And the rest is history. Someone wrote this week, my ice keeps getting bigger, and I thought that's crazy, and now I'm looking at Def Is. Like, ice melts, but I feel like I got the kind that goes the other direction. Oh! Bird Bane mask was a triumph. We all know that. And yet, still a ton of notes. Someone said, that's not how Bane sounds. Well, that's how Bird Bane sounds. I invented him. I get to decide. Someone said the mask should cover the beak because Bane's mask covers his mouth. Well, Bird Bane's different. I invented him. I was told I had a terrible Arnold Schwarzenegger impression. I should get a refund from impressions camp, you said. Here's the thing, rookies. Everyone has an Arnold Schwarzenegger. And one of the things they teach you in advanced impressions camp, which is what I'm now in, is that when everyone has one, the only way to make yours stand out is to do a really bad one. There are certain people, Shatner, Schwarzenegger. I have a terrible walk-in that everybody likes. More cowbell, I'd like some too, please. Keep it coming. I said last week that, NBC was threatening to cancel corrections. Obviously, I was joking when I implied that anybody at NBC knew this existed. Them canceling this would be like breaking up with someone you've never met. We had animation of Donald Trump getting hit in the head with a brick. And many of you said, hey, that's not the sound a brick would make if it hit someone in the head, which is true. But when you're doing a comedy show, you can't do it with the sound it would actually make. So here's what we did.
I don't need to read the bill because I know a bad deal when I... Melania.
And here's how it would sound if it was what you wanted.
I don't need to read the bill because I know a bad deal when I... Melania.
In that same closer look, we had this sort of refined Trump character ask Melania to brew him some chamomile tea because he was going to stay up late. Chamomile tea helps you fall asleep. That makes sense, as it's the most popular in the new Cosby's Own line of teas. Cosby's Own. People said, it's a shame you don't go back to previous Thursday's closer look. I do. Was very excited last week to announce that we had a Gimme the Googs mug now available in the NBC store. Obviously, I'm always excited when we get new merch. Discontinued already. We were immediately sued by the Minnesota Timberwolves. 1998, they sold one of these. I'm the only one who remembers Tom Gugliotta. Made a crack that Teamsters wouldn't appreciate modern art. I was told by someone Teamsters can actually be very knowledgeable about such things. Local 814 includes the handlers, art handlers here at Christie's and Sotheby's, the two biggest auction houses in the world. And I knew I stepped in it last week because when I walked off stage, Kenny said if I insulted his art knowledge again, my face would be more f***ed up than Picasso's Femme au Chien. Australia, we had a joke about a kid got caught in a claw machine in Australia, and the cops got him out, and we said it cost him $15 worth of quarters. Australia does not have a quarter. They have a 1 cent coin, a 2 cent coin, a fuzzle gobber, a kangaroo, a grazzle basil, and a padalalaboggan. Free Willy wasn't his name. The name of the whale was Willy. Free was what they wanted. That was an action. It would be saying like his name was Ask Jeeves. And guys, I don't want to make today waste my time criticizing the end of Free Willy. But it kind of sucks. Because there's this whole plot is like, will the whale have enough oomph to get over this breakwater to freedom? And then the kid stands there. So Willy not only has to jump over the breakwater, got to jump over a 12-year-old kid, too. And I get it. Well, it looks good on a poster, but come on. No. Bail. They don't remember you. They don't remember you. It's not going to work. No. No. Just. Don't milk it. They don't. Get out of here, Googs. Here's my favorite comment of the week. 95th episode of Corrections. 5 to go. 95 episodes of something. What do I do it for? Love of the game. I'm not compensated for corrections. Someone wrote, is there ever anyone else or is it always just this old guy? Then someone else jumped into the comments to describe me as a busted Ash Ketchum. Look it up. Someone said bongos. Larry David and I talked about bongos. We were not complimentary. Someone said, hey, bongos are hard. They're hard to play well. I go so far as to say they're impossible to play well. Should we check in on my fingernails? Should we, when we do it, should we do the bit I had planned last week? Like, this is all just a setup for a bit that I was gonna do and then came up with Birdbane and was so relieved that I then didn't have to do the bit that I'm gonna do now. Are you guys all gonna see in real time how much worse this bit was? And then the triumph that was the Birdbane mask. And would the ending today be better if Bane hadn't broke Ellen's ankle? It would, but I hadn't no recourse but to go back to last week's bit. Let's take a look. Again, not bad. The only problem is I'm focusing so much on my nails, I'm ignoring other personal hygiene. Like, I haven't brushed or flossed my teeth in weeks. Is this anything? Does this work? Someone sent me these. Is this funny? Rudy Giuliani eyes. Is this good? Is this a good ending? I have funny bad teeth and I have Rudy Giuliani eyes. Did I do a good job? Did you guys all leave? See you next week.